watched our last video on Victron Sonius systems, you realized that we monitored our system using the Fronius SolarWeb, and this is the interface of the Fronius SolarWeb. All you have to do is to log in. If you're already registered, then you can access your installation. But for the purpose of today's video, we will be monitoring the system using the VRM portal, and that is the Victron Remote Monitoring Portal. All you have to do is to enter vrm.victronenergy.com into your web browser, then log in if you already have an account. So I'll go straight to the installation we are considering today, and this is it. Now, it gives you information about consumption, about the solar, and also about the battery. It's a very robust tool for monitoring your system. So let's go to the far left and access the remote console. Now, the remote console gives you real-time information about the performance of your system. You can see the AC input, you can see the loads, the battery, and the PV inverter. Now, the VRM portal can give us information about the PV inverter, so you can monitor your Fronius inverter using the VRM portal. You can see that the production is showing 0 watts. The PV inverter is showing 0 watts because of frequency shifting. This happens when the battery is full and the energy generated from the PV inverter is not put to use. The frequency then shifts, so the production of the PV inverter becomes 0 until conditions change. The Victron inverter will control the frequency to prevent overcharging the batteries. So let's briefly go to the advanced, and that's also to your far left. Now, this is for technical personnel. So I'll show you how I can monitor the system and also see some more information. Let me go to the gateway and activate system AC consumption. For your information, the gateway is the GX device, and for this installation we are using the color control GX. So let me activate the PV inverter and activate PV inverter yield. If you go down, you see that those fields that are activated are already shown. I can expand the field, then I can also show information from the past. So I'll go to last 6 months. It gives me information from the last 6 months. So I can expand a particular season to get more information about the performance of the system at that time. Now, at this time, you can see that the consumption is around 2,969. And at that same time, let's come down to the PV inverter yield. You can see around the 3rd of January, the PV inverter is giving us a yield of about 2,371 watts. That's all I'll be showing you today. Thank you very